Hey guys, how are you? Welcome to the Untitled Tarot. My name is Lauren B. I have been thinking lately about doing like a series of sorts on totems. In particular, animal totems. Maybe I'll branch out, but you know that I find symbolism in everything, and animals as well as music speak to me more strongly than anything else. And so I really wanted to talk in particular for the first episode, let's say, about the bear spirit. Today. It's been coming forward pretty strongly lately. And as always, you know, symbolism, it's so personal, the interpretation of it. So what I see and resonate with and interpret in terms of these different animal totems, it may not resonate with you. You may have a different interpretation. And, you know, so I always leave the floor open in always a respectful way for you guys to share your own experiences and how you harness this energy and how you experience it, right? We're all here to learn from each other. So the bear, there's all different kinds of bears, right? There's black bears, there's brown bears, there's polar bears, there's panda bears. Love a panda bear. And the thing that really is over encompassing about the bear spirit for me is that it's very protective. It's extremely protective, not only of its kin, of its kind, of its cubs, but also over its resources as well. There's a certain fearlessness that comes with the bear spirit for me. And what always sticks out is, you know, bears are, they have such a presence to them. So when you're harnessing a bear spirit, it's really talking about the personal presence that you have in terms of your authority and your sovereignty as well. You don't easily just like, what's the saying? Don't poke the bear, right? You don't mess with a bear. You don't do that because they're very regal, right? They have a serenity to them, but there's also this ferocity that you know that they're capable of. And what's beautiful about the bear is they have the ability to kind of ride that balance between having this innate sense of power, but also in being able to harness it and it doesn't just overtake them. They're very meticulous about what they do and when they strike and when they don't strike. And the bear spirit for me, it's extremely maternal as well. There's I see it a lot as like Cancerian energy. I believe some of this energy came out in a little bit of the Cancer reading I just did, because Cancer energy is extremely maternal, right? It's very protective over its cubs. It's very protective over its kind, over its kin. But it also brings in a lot of that divine masculine energy as well, in being very protective, being a good defender, being a good provider, being able to go out and get resources as well. Energy management is also really highlighted in the bear spirit, because bears instinctively know, kind of like the camel, when to go and find resources, right? What it's going to need in the long run, what it's going to need to sustain itself through a winter. So it really also talks about how much energy you're exerting, cost benefit ratio sort of thing, right? It's the amount of energy that I'm going to exert in order to obtain this resource. Is it going to be worth it? Is it going to sustain me throughout the time that I need it to, right? It also talks about your literal energy levels, like when you need to rest, because bears go into hibernation. So it's also about being able to discern when it's your time to sort of fall back, when you're physically exhausted, when you're kind of mentally burned out, burning the candle at both ends sort of energy. When it's time to go back in and rest, recuperate, wait for your season, wait for spring. And, you know, no one sort of goes in and knocks on the cave that a bear lives in while it hibernates and lets it know, like, hey, Smokey, it's spring. Why don't you go out there? No, it instinctively knows when spring has come, and that's it starts to wake up, right? Which is also really a sign of intuitively being able to sense, like, when your season has come, when it's an opportune time to go out there and start pursuing opportunities, right? As a good example, let's talk about, say, dating, right? Maybe you've been through it. You've been through it for a little while. Harnessing the bear spirit would let you know when it is a good time to sort of get back out there. Spring's in the air, love's in the air. Maybe now's a good time for me to go out and start exploring some of my options, right? But it also lets you know when it's, hey, you know, now's not really a good time. I don't really have the energy. I need to recoup a little bit of what I lost. I need to kind of heal, right? It's like sleep. We heal best when we're sleeping. And so maybe I need to go in my cave, I need to heal, I need to rest up, recoup a little bit of that energy that I lost, and then intuitively, instinctively, I'll know, now's a good time. Now's a good time for me to go job hunting. Now's a good time for me to go out there and look for love. Now's a good time for me to try and explore some of these other spiritual aspects of myself, now that I've really kind of recouped some of that energy that I've lost in overexerting myself in other areas. There are all these different kinds of bears too, which I think are really, really beautiful. You know, for instance, we have the black bear, right? That for me really talks about our internal processes, right? When it's time to kind of look inwardly. The black bear often speaks of like perseverance. Perseverance kind of goes throughout all of them, but it really denotes a sense of value, that if things are sort of hidden in the dark, right? If you're sort of hidden, if people cannot perceive you, what you're trying to do, your value, what you're capable of, right? Because maybe you're not striking out, or maybe you're not striking at them, or maybe you're not exerting your dominance or your authority or your sovereignty in a very outward, sometimes even aggressive way, right? Do you still internally see the light within you? Do you recognize your inner strength? Do you recognize your ability to kind of defend yourself, stand your ground, see your own value, right? Now we have things like the brown bear, for instance. Brown, you know, that's the color of the soil, of the earth. So that for me also talks about being really grounded in yourself. Bear spirits also really talk about, brown bear spirits, pardon me, really talk about healing, right? They kind of harness this warrior spirit, this medicine man, this medicine woman sort of aspect energy as well, because, you know, Gaia, the earth, is extremely healing. It has this transmutative energy to it. That's why we do those earthing exercises, right? When you feel really anxious or you feel overstimulated, you feel like you're carrying too much energy, like a battery pack, and you go outside and you experience nature, or you walk barefoot on the ground, and the earth kind of pulls out the excess from you, helps you transmute that added energy, which is in and of itself natural medicine. It's healing, right? So if some of these different kinds of bears are coming to you in a dream, say, like you see a brown bear in a dream as opposed to a black bear, it might really be a call to you to sort of ground your energy, to fortify your strength in yourself, to make it easier for you to recharge your energy, to go out there and look for resources once you're in a little bit more of a balanced and a center place. Whereas if maybe you see a black bear in your dreams, that's really talking about your internal processes of maintaining confidence and strength in knowing your abilities, right? Whether or not they are recognized or illuminated by you from other people, if that makes any sense. We have things like polar bears. Polar bears. Now, what I love about a polar bear, that talks about perseverance more than any other kind of the bear totems, because polar bears, they live in the Arctic. They live in these extremely cold, extremely harsh climates where it's very hard for anything else to grow. But yet, the bear makes it happen. It makes it work, right? So that's about you really harnessing all of your skills and your abilities, harnessing all of your strength, your instincts, your almost your animalistic instincts in whatever challenges, oppositions, the extremities of your experiences that you may be going through. That is something that I really, really love about the polar bear. It almost, for me, kind of relates to the symbolism and the totems behind lilies, right? How lilies grow through mud. They grow through these kind of murky, harsh environments where it would be hard for life to sustain itself most of the time, but yet the lily blooms, and yet the polar bear sustains and it evolves, and better than that, it thrives. It's about really thriving under challenges and under pressures. And then you have something like, say, the polar bear. I love a polar bear, or a polar bear, a panda bear. I love a panda bear. The thing that's really, really cool about the panda bear is that they're black and white, right? So it talks about our polarities, but how when they integrate, we find that sense of peace, because panda bears are really symbolic of peace and prosperity, because when you're in a centered, balanced place, when you're at peace with yourself, when you're at peace in your environment, that allows your energy to flow a lot better, which really promotes things like luck or prosperity or abundance or blessings, because we're not fighting to be on totally in our shadow or totally in our high vibe stuff. We're really riding that sort of middle ground, right? And panda bears, they often kind of go toe-to-toe, hand-in-hand with bamboo. And what I think is really interesting about bamboo is that people will plant it. I know some people that plant it around here, and they use it as a form of noise pollution reduction, right? So it's the ability that also maintaining your peace also oftentimes means blocking out a lot of the external, other people's projections, other people's opinions, other people's values and assessments of who we are and what we're doing and what we're trying to accomplish. Because again, when you can just kind of persevere, trust your natural instincts, your intuition, when it's your time, when to relax, when you need to go forward, when you need to pull back, to kind of maintain your internal strength, right? That creates a sense of peace. And then prosperity can really bloom out from you, because it's always within first, and then we can see it outside of ourselves. So that's just like a little bit of how I interpret the bear spirit. Different kinds of bears. There's a lot of different kinds of bears, but those seem to be sort of like the four main ones that I come across in the readings, in the cards, that I find people deal with in dreams a lot when they ask me for dream interpretations. So yeah, it's my first one. It's my first totem video, so be gentle with me. I'm new here. But I thought it's fun. I thought it was a fun idea that we kind of break down some of the symbolism and the totems that we go through in all of the readings all of the time, and to really kind of sit and take a few minutes and sort of break that down. So as always, you know, that this is how I interpret a lot of these energies. But if you guys are resonating or interpreting them or experience them or even harnessing these energies in different ways, like, I feel free, you know, always in a respectful manner, but open the floor, like, go, we'll share with each other, and we'll see what we get. You know, it takes a village. So I love you guys very much. As always, stay prayed up, stay blessed, stay sweet, stay berry, and I'll see you very soon. Goodbye.